What is the tallest mountain in the world? No, it's not Mount Everest. Traditional knowledge tells us that Mount Everest is the tallest mountain in the world, but the truth is a little more complicated. Depending on how you measure a mountain, Mount Everest might not be the tallest in the world after all. There are a couple of other mountains that would like to have a word and are both able to claim the record on a technicality. If you're looking for a good old, actually fact, you're in the right place. Adventure down the page below to find out about Mauna Kea, the dormant volcano in Hawaii, and to see why it can claim to be the tallest mountain in the world. While Titanic is one of the most widely watched movies in history, we know what fateful end it met. If you haven't watched it yet, spoiler dead ahead. As we swooned over the majestic love story of Rose and Jack, our expectations were shattered by the tragic ending. The Titanic hit a catastrophic iceberg and split in two, finally leading to the separation of the two star-crossed lovers. If all the water from all the oceans was taken out, we would see that the ocean floor is not a plain and flat surface. It also has landforms like mountains and plateaus. Although an iceberg is not one of these landforms, it does confirm our belief that there may be solid masses beneath the surface of the liquid ocean. So, if there are mountains rising from the floor of oceans, is Mount Everest actually the tallest mountain on planet Earth? No. Mount Everest, at 8,150 meters, 29,035 feet, above sea level, undeniably claims the crown as the place with the highest altitude in the world. The title of tallest mountain in the world, however, as measured from the base to its peak, belongs to Mauna Kea, which has an altitude of only 4,005 meters, 13,596 feet, above sea level. The catch: it's a dormant shield volcano on the island of Hawaii with its base about 6,000 meters, 19,700 feet, below the surface of the Pacific Ocean. In other words, more than half of it is submerged. When you add everything up, Mauna Kea is over 10,000 meters tall, way taller than the 8,150 meters of Mount Everest, making it the world's tallest mountain. It's also the tallest volcano on Earth. Mauna Kea is thought to have formed over a hot spot in the Earth's crust, which is a region where magma from the mantle rises up through the crust and erupts onto the surface. The hot spot is thought to have been stationary while the Pacific plate, on which Mauna Kea sits, has moved over it. As the plate moved northwestward over the hot spot, a series of volcanoes formed, with each successive volcano becoming older and more eroded as the plate moved farther away from the hot spot. Mauna Kea is the youngest of these volcanoes, having formed only 1 million years ago, and it is still an active volcano, although it has not erupted in many centuries. Scientists believe that the last time Mauna Kea erupted was more than 45,000 years ago. Mauna Kea is famous for another distinction as well. It is home to the world's largest astronomical observatory, the $1.4 billion 30-meter telescope. At this elevation, the summit is above 40% of Earth's atmosphere, which helps improve its view of distant cosmic objects. The extremely dry and almost cloud-free conditions also help, making it an ideal spot from which to make astronomical observations. Mauna Loa is also a stratovolcano and is the largest volcano on the planet in terms of volume and area covered. It rises to an elevation of 4,169 meters above sea level, making it the second highest mountain in Hawaii, but also the second highest mountain on Earth as measured from base to peak. The plate tectonic theory. To understand the formation of mountains, it is important to know about the plate tectonic theory. According to this theory, the outer layer of the Earth, or the lithosphere, is divided into many tectonic plates. They are irregularly shaped and composed of solid rock. These plates continuously move over the asthenosphere, which is a semi-molten layer. There are seven major and a number of minor plates covering the planet. Since the Earth was formed, the plates have been in continuous motion. This has led to the varied positions of continents over time. It has also led to the formation of new and myriad land masses, such as mountains and volcanoes. This is due to the different kinds of plate boundaries. Plate boundaries are not the boundaries of the continents of today, but actually pass through the continents and even the oceans. There are three kinds of plate boundaries. Divergent boundaries are those where plates move away from each other and new crust is generated. Convergent boundaries are those where plates move towards each other. One plate subducts under another and crust is destroyed. Transform boundaries are those that slide past each other. How did Mount Everest form? The Indian subcontinent used to be a large island around 225 million years ago. It was separated by the Tethys Sea from the Asian continent. Then, 200 million years ago, it started moving northwards towards Asia. Its movement continued for millions of years until about 40-50 million years ago, when it collided with Asia. The collision led to the rapid uplift of crust between the Indian and the Eurasian plate. Thus rose the Himalayan range of mountains. Since plate movement is quite slow, approximately 10 centimeter year, the two plates are still moving into each other. Out of the many peaks of the Himalayan range is Mount Everest, which rose the highest. It took 50 million years for Mount Everest to rise to the height it is today. In fact, it is still getting taller at a rate of 1 centimeter per year. By the way, what about Mauna Kea? How did Mauna Kea form? With a height of more than $10,000 m when measured from the ocean floor, Mauna Kea's process of formation is very different from that of Mount Everest. Apart from different kinds of plate boundaries, there are also places on Earth called hotspots. These are breaks in the Earth through which molten mantle can rise upwards in the form of magma. This mantle erupts from the outer core, where mantle is present in a plastic form. This upwelling of mantle is known as a mantle plume. The regions where mantle plume comes out of the Earth's surface are known as hotspots. The eruption of mantle plume as magma leads to the formation of volcanoes. Island formation takes place as the magma keeps building up on the same place in oceanic regions. One such distinct example of island formation through mantle plume is that of the Hawaiian chain of islands. Mauna Kea is also a part of this chain. The presence of a chain of islands indicates that the plate beneath, the Pacific plate, is in constant motion. If the plate would have remained still, only one large island would have been created. Thus, this process of magma upwelling not only led to the creation of the tallest mountain on Earth, but also one of the world's most famous holiday destinations, the Hawaiian Islands. So, what is the biggest mountain in the solar system? Speaking of stars, or rather celestial bodies within our star system. If we don't limit ourselves to Earth and make a list of the highest mountains in the entire solar system, Earth's Everest would move down to the 27th position. Even Mauna Kea wouldn't make it to the top 10. Clearly, discussing the absolute height of mountains on other planets and their moons is not relevant since they lack both sea level and seas themselves. Therefore, in this list, the height is measured from the base to the summit. Two peaks compete for the first place here. The first is Mount Rhea Silvia, standing in the eponymous crater on the asteroid Vesta. Its height is 22 kilometers, 13.7 miles. The top spot is also claimed by Olympus Mons in the Tharsis region on Mars, with a height of about 22 kilometers, 13.7 miles, if measured from the average planetary level. However, if measured from the surrounding lowlands, it reaches 26 kilometers, 16.2 miles. We will place both peaks in a shared first position. Over time, our knowledge of other objects in the universe will continue to expand, and new lists will include more distant objects with higher mountains. So, we should be cautious with statements like, "the highest mountain in the world." As we can see, even if we consider only our planet, different answers can be given to the question of which mountain is the highest. On Earth, in most cases, the answer would be Everest. However, if we consider the height from the base to the summit, or from the center of the Earth to the most prominent peak reaching into space, the answers would be Mauna Kea and Chimborazo, respectively. Everest doesn't always turn out to be the highest mountain. It is often surpassed even by the seemingly modest African mountain, Kilimanjaro. Long story short, in case you're wondering why Mount Everest is still considered the tallest mountain on Earth, the rationale is quite straightforward. It's the difference in the manner of measurement. Whenever height above sea level is considered, Mount Everest remains the undisputed winner. However, when absolute measurements are taken, Mauna Kea grabs first place. Thanks for watching. To stay updated on the latest discoveries, make sure to subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications.